Welcome back. Let us see how GeoGebra can be used for integer addition, checking the integer addition, how positive plus negative, negative plus positive, how two integer number when they are added, what is the final answer using GeoGebra. For that, we want only one number line, that is in one dimension. For that, select the graphing view, go to this graphics, and you will get its properties, that is the objective properties of this two graphs. In that, go to the y-axis and then don't show it. Okay, in the x-axis also, in the basics, you have minimum as minus 10, then maximum as 10, and in the x-axis, you take the distance as 1. Okay, now you got the total number line here. The grid is also not required, therefore let us remove the grid also. We want to have different additions, therefore let us have sliders for the first integer. Let us have the number minus 10, let us have from minus 10 to maximum, we will have up to 10. It can be increased at any number of times, therefore 1, so let us have the slider 1, therefore this is the first integer. It will be added with the second integer now, which is also, we are taking it as a variable, which is taken as minus 10, and the maximum number is 10, and the increment is 1. Let us have it now. Okay. Now, we want to type something on the input box. Therefore, let us take the input box now. In the input box, let us take the point capital A is equal to 0, 1. The point is taken now. Point is taken. Okay, now what you can do is you can have it at the center so that the addition will be visible to us. Okay, well, okay, let us go to the next one. Capital B is a point which depends on this capital A plus the variable A comma 0, that is, it is being added. For what really happening is, when you enter it, when you are changing this A, whenever you are changing this small a, and it is going on changing. Okay, it changes now. Let us now have another point, capital small u, vector u. We are taking vector u. Vector u is equal to connecting this a and b. Vector connecting a and b. These two points which we have just made. Okay. The thing is, whenever moving it, this vector also moves. Okay, you see, whenever you are moving A, this vector is moving. Well, now we are going for another point, capital C. It is being given in the notes given to you, C plus of 0 comma 1. Please note down the steps. These steps are very, very important. B comma 0 comma 1, another point we have got now on the top of it. And again, we are going for another point D. We have got that C, then C plus, this depends on the small b. Therefore, when you change this small b, this also will change. Now, we are going for the next vector u is equal to vector connecting the which points which you have made now, c comma d. So, this is vector c comma d is a vector. Now, we are taking one point r, which is nothing but x of this d. It is going on changing. It depends on d comma 0. Means it will be on the, you know that it will be on which axis? The y coefficient is 0, y coordinate is 0, therefore it is a point on the x axis. Small x, it should be small x, should be small x, x of d comma 0, the point you have got now. Then now we are going for the origin, because the origin is the place where from where the addition is being defined, integer addition is being defined from the origin. We are going for segments now. This segment can be obtained directly from the box also, but anyway, we are typing it now. Segment z comma a is the first segment. Then the second segment is segment b comma c, capital C. The point connecting b and c is the second segment. Then we are going for the third segment, which also will change, d comma r. D comma r, this is the third segment. Okay. Now, what really happening now is, whenever you are moving this, this addition, I will tell you that addition now, well, it is moving here, it is moving now. Well, let us go for the final answer. Small r is equal to a plus b. Okay, final r is a plus b. Now this one is the answer. Therefore, we will make it a little bit decorative. We will take it style as a little bit bigger one, and then make it the color as red and okay. Now that is going to be the final answer actually. Well, now we to show the answer to the children, we can have a text here. In the text, we are going to add a and b. Therefore, let us keep the small a inside. Within the bracket, I am putting because sometimes it may be negative also. Again, I am putting b in inside. Therefore, b. Okay, final answer which we are going to get is equal to r, which we have taken r as a plus b. Okay, this is r. Okay, now we are getting it as 8 plus 5 is equal to 13 over here. Well, we will make it a little bit decorative. Right click, go to object properties, go to the text, and then make it as very large, and then bold it and give a color to it. Well, okay, now we got that 8 plus 5 is equal to 13. Let us see how it actually happened when you are going on making it as negative now. Okay, minus 5 plus 5, it goes up to minus 10, and again 5 is being added. Okay, therefore it comes back to minus 5. Okay, this is the minus 5 here. When you are going on changing here, it goes to the negative. Negative minus 10 plus of minus 6. Minus 10 and minus 6 is minus 16. When you are changing it, then it goes to the positive side now. For 10 plus minus 6, therefore it goes up to the 10 in the right hand side now. Minus 6 means it has to come to the left hand side. For you are very well seeing here, whatever the positive side, it goes to the left to right, and the negative is from right to left. But actually the vectors are actually showing you. Now here both are going in the right direction, you see. 10 plus 3 is 13. But when you just go on changing it, you see, both are in positive direction now. When you are changing it negative, it goes to the negative side. For now, at any place, you can ask the child that how the addition of two integers being explained through GeoGebra. Thank you.